Hello and welcome to this new video from ABI Electronics. I'm speaking from ABI's main office in Barnsley, South Yorkshire in England. This week we are training some of the engineers from the Irish Rail. The Irish Rail is Ireland's national railway operator. Sitting next to me, I've got Ray Holden. Ray is the electronics facility repair manager. Hello, Ray.
Hello, how are you?
I'm good, how are you?
Not so bad.
Thanks a lot for agreeing to speak to us.
You're welcome.
So what can you tell us about your background in the rail industry?
I started in 2006 as a commissioning engineer with CAF, mm-hmm. Spanish rail manufacturer. And I was working there for about a year and a half, mm-hmm. 2 years nearly. Mm-hmm. And that project was finished, and then I moved on. Irish Rail offered me a job, and so that's how I got into that. Initially, just electrical work, fault finding, that kind of stuff, because I knew all the systems, mm-hmm. From working with the manufacturer. So it was a kind of an easy transition,
you know. Right.
Mm-hmm. From there, you know, we've come a long way in that time.
Now, I understand that you set up the electronic repair facility at the Irish Rail. Is that right?
Yeah.
So when and how did that come about?
Well, you had a big problem with parts availability back in, 07, 08. It was the thought of a component from a train, it would be sent away. You might not get that back for 6-9 months. Mm-hmm. In the meantime, we wouldn't have a massive amount of stock available, so trains were taken out of service. This was a very, very popular practice to remove parts from one train and put them into another to send that train out in service.
Right.
When you fill your day doing that, it's soul destroying. You're there to fix things, you know, learn. It's not the way to go. Mm-hmm. What we started doing was just taking, parts that were basically been thrown in the bin, mm-hmm. and some parts that were going away, and seeing what we could do.
Right.
Just as a part-time thing, mainly on nights. Mm-hmm. So that kind of developed then, and then you could see that there was parts availability, and within a year, there was no parts been robbed from one train to another. It's gone from there, you know. I put a proper business plan and it's been supported wholeheartedly by the chief mechanical engineer and the fleet managers. They totally have bought into it.
Right.
You know.
Good. Right. And in terms of the internal repairs, what do you think, or why do you think internal repairs provide a better value for money for urban organizations? And can you think of some examples?
Internal repairs. Well, one thing about doing internal repairs is, number one, you're going to get the product back in a timely manner. Mm-hmm. It's far more cost effective. Mm-hmm. But what we've found now, as an added bonus, the more we're in depth, we're getting into every system. Is that we're coming up with suggestions where we can actually make things better. Or we might suggest a preventive maintenance task based on some common failures that would have before. Mm-hmm. That was never done before. It was failing, that was it, it was replaced, and had a huge cost. Now the cost has come down. We have a rolling average on our SAP system for our stores and inventory. And it's year on year and year, that price is coming down.
I'm looking into the future. So how do you see the future of electronic repair in the rail sector?
It has to be. It has to get huge, because the obsolescence is always the issue. Supplier support is always the big issue, mm-hmm. Or lack of. It's up to people to try and take this on themselves and move with it and do some internal repairs. There's a big emphasis now particularly with Irish Rail to reverse some of the mentality from years ago where everything was outsourced. Mm-hmm. There's a big push on trying to do stuff internally now. At the end of the day, it's going to offer better value to the taxpayer. It makes sense to keep something in-house. as far as broadening the scope, I don't see any reason to limit what we're doing. I think expand it,
mm-hmm.
But expand it with view of improving what's already there,
mm-hmm.
And I think that's going to make sense. But that's where the real business is, as far as electronics in the way is improving what's there.
Now, you were a big believer in giving chances to young people on developing new talents. What would be your advice to education providers and electronic students with regards to opportunities in the rail industry?
The rail industry's changed an awful lot from your base trades, electricians to fitters, mechanics, body makers. It's dramatically changed now. Mm-hmm. Everybody's going for all-in-one technician jobs. Mm-hmm. That's the future, but more so now than ever, it's quite important to get in and have a hands-on approach in electronics. I found that myself. I came from an electrical background, mm-hmm. and then mechanical, and then electronic.
Mm-hmm.
And all of my previous experience has all been used today, mm-hmm. in the railway, because it has every facet of all those trades, all of one. So I think it's very important for new apprentices, coming into the company, to have a very, very good understanding of electronics, because that is for the future. Mm-hmm.
Right, so you've been here with ABI for 4 days now, and working very hard and going through the training. So I appreciate all the hard work that you're putting into that, as well as all the guys. So what has been your experience with ABI so far, and can you tell me what led you to choose our test and repair systems?
Yeah, look, this week has been a real eye-opener. We've got the equipment. We were using it, but only to a very limited, scope. Now, I have to say, it's just the world of possibilities. Just, mm-hmm. they're all out there. So I were very, very enthusiastic now about going back and creating something special using this equipment, because we know its capability is absolutely colossal. So we want to get the best out of that. So some time ago, we purchased a Chipmaster.
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm. We've had that for a number of years, mm-hmm. and to great success. We love it. Mm-hmm. Nice, neat machine, mm-hmm. for verifying our ICs.
And just explain for those watching, the Chipmaster is an out-of-circuit digital IC tester that ABI produces. Okay.
Oh, it's incredible. Mm-hmm. The machine, mm-hmm. Very easy to use, and mm-hmm. that was the start of it. And then, through YouTube, and mm-hmm. then you made contact mm-hmm. through the guys up in Inchicore in mm-hmm. the main offices,
mm-hmm.
and I was blown away.
Mm-hmm.
The more research I did into the product,
mm-hmm.
the more possibilities it presented.
Mm-hmm.
Can we do this? Can we do that? We intend on using this as an integral part of all repairs,
mm-hmm.
the system, and using the system 8, mm-hmm. to drive our new repairs in the future.
Good, good. Happy with the choice that you made?
Delighted. Absolutely
okay.
delighted.
Okay.
And it will go from here.
Right, good.
Okay. Onwards and upwards.
Good, good, very good. Well, thank you very much, Ray. I'll let you go back into the training then. And thanks for watching this video. If you'd like to know more about ABI, go to abielectronics.co.uk. You can also find us on Twitter, LinkedIn, and YouTube. Or you can also Google hashtag repair don't waste to find out more about how other customers are using our systems and how successful they've been. Thank you.